Hello, my dear. You look a bit ragged.
Well, maybe that's because everything we've been working for, everything we've put in place, is about to blow up in our faces.
What makes you think so?
That enforcer you hired?
Sean Butler?
Yes, him. He spent last night at General Hospital, singing like a bird, telling Detective Spencer everything he knows about you.
Well, isn't it fortunate that that doesn't amount to very much? Relax, my dear. It's being handled as we speak.
I hope you're not going to be annoyingly secretive.
About?
The plans you have for Sean Butler.
All will be revealed.
Annoyingly secretive.
A trait I happen to share with my wife.
Oh, yes. But unlike me, you take it a step further. Like last night, you flat out lied to me.
I did?
You denied knowing anything about the limo explosion.
Oh, that.
It was brilliant. Switching Sam McCall for Brenda in front of God and everyone.
It was rather bold, if I do say so myself. However, Sonny takes his bomb-proofing a bit more seriously than I expected. No matter, the results were stellar, and Brenda is in my custody.
Where?
Oh, no need to worry about details.
You know, Theo, after all these years we've been together, you know what I'm hearing? You don't trust me.
You can't possibly believe that.
You didn't even tell me Brenda was alive.
So that your shock and devastation could appear real to the people around her. So you could avoid suspicion. I was protecting you, as I always have and always will. You, my dear, are absolutely the only person I do trust. Miss Barrett, I trust you passed a comfortable night.
I don't think there's anything comfortable about being held prisoner, is there?
Right. But don't look so troubled. This certainly is better than the alternative, isn't it?
And what would that be?
Well, you were drugged and extracted from the limo just before it went boom.
I want you to tell me if Sonny's okay.
Oh, your new husband is fine, but understandably distressed as he believes you were blown to pieces.
And why is that?
I had the foresight to leave a body in your place. I couldn't very well have Sonny looking for you, could I?
So obviously you know that's how Lily died. And now you want Sonny to think that I've died the same way. That's pathetic.
Actually, it's meticulous planning. But I'll pat myself on the back later on. I've been anxious to get to that talk I've wanted to have with you for so long.
What in the world could we possibly have to talk about?
My grandchild.